Welcome to the walkthrough video for Lab 5. Lab 5 is a little different from the other labs in that it asks you to do some data modeling. And this is different from most of the other labs, which involve writing SQL queries. So I'm going to start with an example that's different than the example you're going to be asked to do. You're asked to model a database for a grocery store chain. And what I'm going to do is something that you should all be familiar with. So here's the scenario. A student signs up for a particular course in a given semester. The course is taught by an instructor at a scheduled time in a specific classroom. Instructors work for departments on a semester-by-semester basis. Individual departments are part of a subject area committee who administer the course. And at the end of the term, the student receives their grade for the course. So, where do we begin? Well, question one asks you to identify the entities and relationships in the scenario. So here's a quick definition for entity, attribute, and relationship. So an entity is a collection of things of a particular type. So for example, all of the students at PCC might be represented by a student entity. So we might have a student entity that represents a set of individual students. An attribute is a property of an entity. So for example, a student can have a first name and a last name and a GPA, and they can have a major and a home address and so on. Each of these different values is an attribute of the student entity. And finally, a relationship is a connection between two or more entities. And often these reflect verbs in the real world. So for example, a student enrolls in a class, a student gets a grade, a student applies for financial aid. The verbs in those sentences, the things that are being done by one entity to or with another entity, those are the relationships between the entities. So let's start working through this from the top. And I'm going to confess that I actually worked through this example on paper a few times just to sort of try to get all of the boxes to look reasonable in the right places. Because when you first start to do this, you're going to get a lot of crossing lines until you sort of move things around. So this already has a little thought into it. But I'm going to start with a student signs up for a particular course in a given semester. So let's begin with a student entity. And I'm going to show that this is an entity by drawing a rectangle around it. And student is an entity because there are going to be multiple students and all students are the same type of thing. And then I'm going to have a course entity. And a student signs up for a course. So signs up for is a relationship between student and course. And I'm going to call that enrollment. And put a diamond around it to show that it's a relationship. So student, enrollment, course. Then this enrollment happens for a particular semester. And there's two ways of dealing with the semester. You can either make semester be an attribute of one of these entities, probably course, or you can make a semester be an entity itself. So is semester an entity or an attribute? The decision really comes down to whether you think of a semester as being a single value or not, in which case it would be an attribute of some other entity, or whether you think that a semester is a collection of attributes itself. So if you think of fall 2016 as being one value, then you might want to make it an attribute of course. But if you think that fall 2016 is two or more values, for example, a term and a year, then you'd want to make it an entity. And I don't think there's really a right or wrong answer here, but for me, I actually view the semester as being a collection of values. So I'm going to go ahead and create a semester entity. And then that's going to be part of this enrollment relationship. So student enrolls in a course for a given semester. And that's the first line here. So the second line, the course is taught by an instructor at a scheduled time in a specific classroom. So instructor is going to be an entity. And the student is enrolling in a course that's taught by an instructor in a given semester. And then the course itself is taught at a particular date and time. And once again, this could be an attribute of course or an entity in a given classroom. So these are all part of the enrollment relationship. So instructors work for departments on a semester by semester basis. So let's go ahead and add department. And works for, which is a relationship between instructor, department, and semester. Individual departments are part of a subject area committee who administer the course. So here's a SAC entity, because there are multiple SACs. And a part of relationship to show that departments are part of SACs. And then SACs administer courses. And that's a relationship between SAC and course. At the end of the term, the student receives their grade for the course. Now, grade is just one piece of information, so here I'm not actually going to create a grade entity. I'm just going to treat that as a property of one of these other entities. And this is basically all you need for question one of your design lab. Just sort of an informal collection of the entities and relationships for the problem.